There is something really strange going on with the Stone Cold Steve Austin Funko Pop at 7-Eleven. Let's talk about it. Heather and I are not fans of wrestling, aka WWE, but we know all about Funko and when Funko has problems, and there's a huge problem going on with Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Did they forget to put him by the Slurpees this time?
According to my photo, they have them in front of the hot dogs.
That's the problem.
So it isn't often that 7-Eleven gets an exclusive Funko Pop. We know that they got the Chimichanga Deadpool a while back. They also got a version of Carl from The Walking Dead a long time ago.
The bloody one.
They also got Rey Mysterio, yet another WWE character. And the fact that they get them so rarely is such a great thing because 7-Eleven has no idea what they're doing when it comes to Funko Pops.
No. Do you want to hear something about our 7-Eleven? Do you?
Yeah.
Do you?
I don't know why you're asking. All I gotta do is say it.
I know, but I'm asking you if you want to hear about it.
What am I gonna say? No? Ask me again.
Do you want to hear about our 7-Eleven?
No. Anyway, you see? I mean, this doesn't work.
Do you want to hear about it?
I do, please. I need to know.
They got four in, and they sold all four to the same person.
Holy crap. How'd you find that out?
I don't know.
What? What do you mean you don't know?
Someone told me.
Oh, so you're just gonna believe whatever you hear on the streets?
Yes. I don't think they actually only got four, though, because I think Funko ships orders in sixes.
Well, the photo that I have, like I said, has a lot. Like, maybe 20 or so?
That might be 52.
So I collected a lot of comments about this Funko Pop that I found around on the interwebs today. But before we get started, we want to tell you about our Patreon. Head over to patreon.com/gasslecast to find out all the ways that you can support the channel. Every dollar counts and it helps us create better content, have better giveaway items, and also have better things to unbox for you on every video.
And you want to know something else that it does? They're not guessing.
You have a channel. You can just tell them things.
Oh, I don't have to wait?
No, it's same with me and asking questions. I don't know what's happening.
Oh, okay. If you're a tier 2 or tier 3 patron, which is $5 a month or $10 a month, you get to join a Google Meet with Chris and I every single month. And tier 3 also gets a shot at a couple of cool giveaway items. It's awesome. We try to make it fun, and I think we're doing a good job.
One of April's giveaway items is this Bigfoot. This guy's awesome.
He is. It's the Canadian convention one that's flocked.
Yes, and he even has the Fan Expo exclusive sticker on him. So head over to patreon.com/gasscast to find out more. Okay, so the first weird thing that happened with Stone Cold Steve Austin at 7-Eleven is the fact that they shipped them all out to the stores without stickers.
You know what's really weird?
Are we really going to do this again?
Do you know what's really weird?
Do we have to do this?
Chris?
Heather?
We're never going to end this video.
I think we
will. Do you know what's really weird?
What?
They're showing up to stores with the 7-Eleven stickers now. So at first they were making people contact Funko and say, hey, here's a picture of my receipt. Here's a picture of my Funko Pop. It doesn't have a 7-Eleven sticker. Can you send one to me? And then they would send them to you. But they made you send all these pictures to them.
It's ridiculous. And that's more money that Funko has to spend to send out all those stickers to the fans.
Yeah, I mean, a stamp costs, what, 55 cents now? Or maybe even more? I don't even know.
Well, you're not even factoring in the time and the effort of the people on the other side, packing them all up, responding to people who want stickers. I mean, this is a huge blunder from Funko. I mean, Funko needs to figure out this whole sticker thing. This is not the first time that it happened.
It isn't. And you forgot something.
Did you ask a question and I didn't say what to it?
No, you just forgot the price of the actual envelopes that they send them in.
Oh, and that too.
Yeah. It's really expensive, and I don't understand why they wouldn't just put the freaking sticker on the box and ship it that way.
You know what that is?
A waste of money?
Trash!
Oh, yeah, that too.
Okay, so that's the first problem with these Funko Pops. The second problem is that they're being sold at 7-Eleven. And the problem with that is that people are getting different prices from the people working at 7-Eleven.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say that they get like hot dog grease stains.
Well, that probably also, and maybe a little chilly too. Because I collected a comment today that says, my 7-Eleven asked me how much I want to pay since they are going for 3,000. Yes, 3,000. I'd left the store. So this store is basically saying, what are you willing to pay?
I would say $5, you
And then another person went to their 7-Eleven in their hometown, and they left a comment that I have a very hard time reading. No franchise ones, I guess franchised 7-Elevens,
yes,
carried the Stone Cold. I don't know why, but it's pretty much what 7-Eleven told me. And then, of course, on Funko Finders and on Dis Funko, people were selling their Funko Pops of Stone Cold in the comment section. One guy said, I got some guys, 65 shipped.
Very generous.
This is on a picture of a bunch of Stone Colds at 1-7-Eleven. How dare he do this? Because now they're actually showing up with the stickers and everything in probably abundance. And then I collected a bunch of other comments for, you know, shits and gigs. This guy goes, flippers are sweating now.
Well, it did warm up over the weekend, so.
This person said something that I thought was maybe the funniest comment. Pops smelling like hot dogs and chicken wings.
It's true. I always smell like 7-Eleven when I walk out of 7-Eleven.
This person says, yeah, till one jagoff buys them all to flip online like a d-. This guy's not happy about all this. This person said, I think the 7-Eleven in my town are too hood. there's no way they're carrying these 7-Eleven Stone Cold Steve Austins. Nobody wants them there.
Oh my goodness.
And then we have an angry Canadian who says, wish 7-Eleven in Canada carried these. We don't get squat for exclusives. Well, truthfully, the rest of the world doesn't really get squat for exclusives at 7-Eleven either.
I didn't even know 7-Eleven existed outside of America. It just seems like a very American thing.
It really does, yeah.
Hot dogs and sugary ice.
Yeah, sweaty dogs and Slurpees. It's just, that just seems very American. So it's interesting. These Funko Pops were really hard to find at first, with no sticker. Then they start showing up in droves with the sticker. And people are still having a hard time. And even worse, people can't get a clear answer on what the price is. Isn't there a problem with that?
There is a huge problem with that.
Can you imagine going to Target and saying, I really love that Homelander Funko Pop. And you go up and you go to check out and the person's like, hey, that Homelander, I'm seeing that go for about $90 on Mercari and on eBay. What are you thinking? And so they've already scanned your socks. They've already scanned your new pair of underpants. They've scanned your milk or Doritos or whatever. And now you're going
through our weekend shopping list.
Exactly. Well, that's what I'm saying.
You literally bought socks and underpants this weekend.
I really did because I noticed that they were ridiculously disgusting. I have no idea how you allow me to run around in those things. It looked like I had been attacked by a pack of hyenas.
Listen,
in those underpants.
I don't know how...
How does the butt get ripped completely out? Answer that. I don't know how your entire buttocks gets ripped out of the underpant. How does that happen? No, I did not fart in them. And no, I didn't do a poopy either.
You fart a lot.
Not as much as you. But anyway, let's get back to the story. You're in Target and now you're held at practically gunpoint to buy your Homelander Funko Pop. And they're asking, what price are you willing to pay? How can this even happen, 7-Eleven? What are you doing? If you go in there, what are you going to be held up on your sweaty hot dog? You think you might want to pay $7 instead of $5? Like, what's happening?
Did you really say that someone who works at Target would hold a gun to your head?
No, but you know what I'm saying. Like, they're basically holding you by your balls to see how much you're actually going to spend.
Well, they can really hold you by your balls with those holy underpants.
They're getting right in there deep, deep and hard.
Ew.
I'll tell you one thing. If Stone Cold Steve Austin knew anything about this, he would totally do something about it. He'd give a stunner to all those 7-Eleven employees. You ever see a stunner? Kicks the person in the groin. Then he turns around and he grabs their head like this. And he carries them.
Okay.
He drops to... No, I'm showing you.
No.
But he drops you straight to the ground. He does like full legs all the way down as he's carrying you. And then your chin hits here and then you fall. And then he pins you. That's how he does it.
That's horrible.
I know. I really like that I did part of the move to you.
Why would anybody like want to hurt somebody?
If you're a wrestler,
like
you like
that.
To roll like that.
No. Oh my gosh. You can't sign up for that.
I was hoping that maybe I could,
No.
Give you a stunner later on tonight in the bedroom. I know you can't wait.
That's disgusting.
Guys, what do you think about this whole Steve Austin debacle? We would love to know.
Were you able to get one? Do you even care about it? And what do you think about 7-Eleven carrying Funko Pops? Let us know all of that and more in the comments section down below.
And what do you think about the employees asking what people are willing to pay? Isn't that trash? That's trash.
Yeah, I would fire somebody over that. If you are a part of the Gastrocast We Hunt Together group, you've probably heard of a girl named Paige. She was on the transplant list and finally was able to get her new kidney and liver.
Now that's awesome.
Her dad contacted me this morning to let me know that she is recovering so well. Paige, we wish you a very speedy recovery and we love you.
We hunt together. We recover together. Get well soon. Guys, if you're looking for a special Funko Pop, Funko Soda, or Funko Mystery Mini, head over to poppinofftoys.com. They have all the Funko items that you're looking for. poppinofftoys.com. All right, guys, that time again. Remember, as always, we hunt together, guys. We'll catch you next time.
Bye.